the main device, the main controller on the car is a device called op-amp or amplifier, but we're using the amplifier as a comparator. Okay. So the first one, the comparator. So the symbol of the device looks like this. And you just need to know what this guy does for you. And that's pretty much everything. We call this VM because it's V minus, the minus terminal. And the other one is V plus, and this is V out. So what this one does for you is it amplifies the difference between the two terminals. So V out equals to VP minus VM and times the gain. We call it AV, the amplification of the voltage. And you should know that AV is huge. And you don't need to know why, because it's related to the integrated circuit design inside. You don't need to consider about that. Just need to know what this device does, which is very simple. It just amplifies the difference between the two terminals. And you know voltages, right? So this is a V, this is voltage at this point, this is voltage at this point. So V out equals to this minus this times the gain. And the gain is huge. And you powered up your this device using, what did I use? 5 volts and ground. So it's very simple, just five terminals of the device. Just connect the terminal to the correct locations on the board. So 5 volts, just power it up. I will give you a power supply module. And that's a ground pin, just short it to the same common ground of the circuit. And these are the two signal inputs. So let's see, if I'm gonna draw a VP for you, for example. For example, that's VP. This voltage, this is time. So that's VP, that's a voltage level here. And VM is something different. So that's VM. So this is VM. One of the property over here is, for example, if I have 2 volts, VP equals to 2 volts, VM equals to 1 volt, and AV equals to 1,000. So let's do a calculation. VO equals to VP minus VM times 1,000, which is 1 volt times 1,000. So what are you expecting? A 1,000 volts for VL, which is impossible. You don't even have a power supply to support it. So the maximum voltage you can get is actually 5 volts, even though it's trying to get to 1,000 volts. But because of the limitation of the power supply and the circuit inside couldn't handle the 1,000 volts, so it's going to saturate at 5 volts very quickly. So which means whenever you have a huge gain here, or amplification, a gain, something, you can call it a gain, then it's gonna saturate VL really quickly whenever you have an even tiny difference between the two terminals. Is that correct? So when VP is slightly larger than VM, it's gonna saturate the output to 5 volts quickly. All right? If we do the other way, like VM equals to 2 volts, VP equals to 1 volt, and VP minus VM, which is VO, times 1,000 equals to minus 1 volt times 1,000, which is minus 1,000 volts. Is that possible? What's the lowest voltage potential in the circuit? Ground, which is 0 volts. So you're not getting a negative 1,000. You're getting? Zero. Here, you are getting 5. all right? Because the two inputs are normally, so it's changing like this, VP, VM, it's changing like this. So what are you expecting for the output? Let's see, okay? In this period, in this time frame, you know, anything before this point, which is larger, which is smaller? VP is larger than VM. So what's a VL should be? What's next? Who is larger, who is smaller? VM is larger, VP is smaller, right? So what do we expect for the output? So what that looks like? What output looks like? Just zero, right? Boom. Is that correct? Until where? Until here. Is that correct? Because after that, VP is larger than VM again. Then what's next? Five. That making sense? Okay, so that's how the comparator works over here. And the input signals are actually the signals being received by the IR receiver. Let's take a look. All right, so look at this circuit. So this is the IR emitter. That's the IR receiver. So light is gonna be transmitted to here and make the channel open. So there are two sensors. One is like a normal LED light emitting diode. The LED you can see on the market, but actually it's emitting IR light instead of a visible light. So you couldn't see that. So the sensors are, if you look at the PCB board, okay, so you have one here, there's a little plastic piece to block, you know, these two parts, so it's not talking to each other, and it's going to emit IR to the top, upward. Okay, there shouldn't be anything being received by this guy because there's no reflection normally. So whenever you put something on the top, Okay, so this error light will be reflected and being received by the receiver. Okay, and then make this conductive. So don't need to worry about what's going on here. So just remember that when this guy receives light, it becomes conductive, like a wire. So whenever this guy receives light, it performs like a wire. So this point will be shorted to where? When light is received, this point will be shorted to where? To the ground. If there's no light being received, which means it's a disconnect circuit, so no current, because remember one thing, no current can get into here, it's just comparator, it's comparing voltages, so no current going to the right side, okay? So this is the only circuit can allow the current flow in there, same here. So when there's no light being received, this is a disconnect circuit, so no current, no voltage drop. So what's the voltage here? If this is disconnected, no current, it's going to be 5 volts because there's no voltage drop, no current, no voltage drop, right? 5 volts. Okay? So in that case, receiving light or not receiving light, you are getting 0.5 volts. You got a signal. Okay. And that's a voltage divider. It's a potentiometer, which you can adjust. So it's pointing to the middle. So something like this. Five volts. I'll say 5K. So what is the voltage here? Everyone. What is the voltage here? If it's 5 volts, 5K, what's the voltage here in the middle? And why? What's the voltage here? So how to get that? So the current flow through this resistor will be 0.5 amps times 5K, which is 2.5 volts. So you are getting a 2.5 volts drop across this resistor. This is 0 volts, so this will be 2.5 volts. And also, you can think about this one as a voltage divider. Remember the equation? Because these are the only two resistors you have in the circuit. You totally have 5 volts, so it's going to divide your 5 volts into two halves. So every resistor will share 2.5 volts across it. So 2.5 volts, 2.5 volts, right? So you'll know this is 2.5 volts. And it's the same concept when you have something like this. You just merge, you just put the two resistors together, two 5Ks, but you merge it and make a 10K resistor and have a pin in the middle. The same concept. You have 5 volts, and you have one 10K resistor, and ground. So it's dividing. If you put this wiper in the middle, it's dividing. So the voltage is being divided by 2, right? So what's the voltage at this pin compared to ground? Yeah. So this is serving as a reference voltage. which is Vp. If you look at the waveform here, Vp is 2.5 volts. And Vm depends on the signal, right? So it's changing. The reason is you have a signal here is changing depending on the intensity of the signal being reflected to the receiver. So this is changing like this. So you are getting this. So it is turning on and off the motor. So when the car is following the line, so for instance, here is a black line in the middle. And you have a receiver, a meter and receiver. Okay. That's a receiver. Same thing here. So that's under, so these are the IR pairs underneath the car. If it's following the line, which is fine, but actually it's not going normally doing that because it's not a straight line. So the car is going to move. You know, that's a car. Just going forward, no problem. However, whenever you have something like this, so that's a black tape on the board. And it's not following the line anymore, it's turning left, for example. So something like this. You have this on the top of the tape. And what's going to happen? So given that, the IR pairs will, so that's the emitter, is sending the IR light outside, okay? It's only being reflected by the light color surface, like white paper or whiteboard. Whenever it's black, the light will be absorbed and nothing will be reflected to the receiver, okay? So that means if this sensor, this pair of sensors is on the top of white background, what's going to happen? If this sensor right now is on the top, is above a white color surface, what's going to happen? Let's start from here and do analysis. If it's white, what's going to do? What this will do? White, then reflective or not reflective? Reflective. So light will be received and becomes a wire. What's the voltage here? Becomes a wire, what's the voltage here will be? This becomes a wire, so it's like this point is being directly shorted to the ground, so it becomes 0 volts. 0 volts for Vm. What's the voltage here? It's not changing, right? We already adjusted the voltage here. What's the voltage here? 2.5 volts. So 2.5 volts is higher than or lower than 0 volts. Higher. So if you apply this equation here, what's the output will be? What is the output? Vp is higher than Vm. Right? Vp is higher than Vm. So Vp minus Vm is something, right? 2.5 times 1,000 is huge. It's going to saturate the output to 5 volts. So it's outputting a 5 volts, a logic high here. Whenever it's on the top of, above a white color, a white background, you are getting 5. that making sense? Okay. If it's above black surface, so the IR will be absorbed by the surface and no reflection, no signal being received. So disconnect circuit, nothing, no current, right? What's the voltage here and why? Why? Okay, so no current, no voltage drop, so 5 volts. Is 5 volts higher or lower than 2.5? Higher, so what's the output? Zero, so you're getting zero whenever it's black. Okay, and now take a look. We have a black tape and white surface, right? So whenever you put the car like this, bridge the black tape on two sides, are the sensors above the white or black surface? White. What's the output signal of the comparator? 5. So 5 volts will turn on the motor. It's a power up, right? So we're going to turn on the motor. Will that work? So the definitely when it's like this, it's going to keep going forward. Right. However, whenever it's doing this, what's going to happen? This is on the top of the black. This is on the top of the white. So what's going to happen for this wheel? Going to stop. So it's like whenever it's doing this, this will keep rolling. This will stop. What's going to happen? Turn to the right. So move it back to the track. And then you got white on the two sides and keep moving forward again. The same concept of when it's turning to the left. It's gonna move it back to the track. That's how that works. It's working, it's doing super fast. So whenever it's out of track, it's gonna adjust the position really quickly and move it back to the track. So that's what you wanna do for this project. It's pretty simple. And if we look at the driver, so here's one thing you need to know. You are not directly connecting this output to the motor because this is being controlled by a low power supply. So you do need actually it's called a buffer. You don't need to know why is that, but let's just connect this to a buffer. So the buffer has more capability, excuse me, to drive the motor. So don't want to directly connect this one to the motor to turn on and turn off the motor. You need something else in the middle. It's pretty simple. You just need to make the connections. If you take a look at this one, okay, that's the ideal one because we fix it, use a customized chip. But the IR module you are going to use inverted these two pins. So actually, whenever it's on the top of the black, you can turn on the motor. So you have to invert it. So there's a device called inverter. You know, if these two pins are swapped, then you are getting a signal opposite to the signal you are expecting. And you need to use the inverter. So for example, the signal comes out from the op-amp. Operational amplifier, which is op-amp for short. Okay, so the signal comes out from the op-amp or being used here as a comparator. It's doing this, for example. Okay, and you convert it to an inverter. Remember, inverter is inverting the signal. It's like the logic you learned last time. A is the case, you invert it, it's inverting that case. So one invert is what? Zero. Zero invert is what? One. So here, because you have this, that's actually a digital signal. 5 volts is considered as logic one. This 0 volts is considered as logic zero. Doesn't matter, it's just on and off, right? 1, 0, on and off, 5, 0. You know, sometimes it's not 1 volt. The 1 volt is normally too low. So we probably want 5 volts, 3.0 volts, 10 volts, things like that. But however, you only have two states in the circuit, right? Zero or not zero. So the state, which is not zero, will be considered as one. It's logic one, it's not 1 volt, okay? So that's one, that's zero. One is 5 volts, okay? It's just, so that's the name of the 5 volts. The name is one. That's an inverter, and because you have this signal, for example, comes from the output, and you invert it, what's gonna happen for this signal? It's 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, trying to be one here. It's gonna be inverted, okay? If you just draw the signal here, it's gonna be 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. All right? Because the sensor you are going to use, the sensor module you are going to use has a different connection compared to ours. So you have to connect the inverter to the output to make it work, which is not hard. Pretty simple. And just do it, then it's gonna work. Okay. So let me see anything else you need to know. Okay, the driver. Definitely. Yeah, so that's a driver. Where is the circuit? That one. Yeah, I should delete that circuit. Okay. I think it's better to have a circuit to look at. So that's the driver's chip, integrated circuit chip. Let's look at, oh, here, that's a connection. Okay. So that's an inverter. That's a driver, which is this guy. Okay, so the output of the comparator should be connected to, okay, no, that's the comparator, actually. So the comparator's output should be connected to here and here. So it is turning on, turning off the motor, because the motor is being shorted to this driver. So the output of the comparator, keep in mind, because it's not that capable to drive your motor. So the output here has to be connected to the driver first. It's just a switch, like a switch. You're turning on here, you turn on here, you turn on the driver, which will turn on the motor directly. Okay, so for example, here is the output of one of the comparator. You have two comparators, because you have two wheels. So that's one of the output is being shorted to here, which will turn on the driver, which will turn on the motor. Okay, that's the other comparator's output. It's going to turn on the driver from the other side of the driver. And that's the main connection for this driver. So all the rest of them are just either being shorted to the power or being shorted to the ground. Pretty simple. Is that clear? So that's the connection. And if you look at the board, and that's the driver, okay? That's the driver I just mentioned. And that's the inverter, okay? So this chip has a couple of inverters inside, right? You just need to use two of them. You have to control the two wheels. And this is a commercial module. I would directly give it to you. It's providing the 5 volts power supply to the circuit. And you need a little plug-in to power it up using your battery, which is giving you 7.4 volts from the battery cartridge. And this board will stabilize the 7.4 volts to 5 volts. So 7.4 volts will be too fast. And based on this not intelligent car, it won't be able to follow the line. It'll go out of track really quickly. So you don't want to drive the car too fast. So 7.4 volts will make it too fast. That's why we have to use a voltage regulator to step down the voltage from 7.4 to 5. So that's what this one does. And it's just plug and play, very simple. So these are the two modules, okay, two IR modules. We make this project way easier than the students in Circuit 1 class, the normal engineering class, because they don't have to connect everything on this module. So this module is available. I give it to you. Just connect everything to the board, and it's going to start working, hopefully. Okay, so let's look at this again, right? Battery, 7.4 volts being delivered to this port. And this module will stabilize the 7.4 volts to 5 volts to support everything here. Okay? And that's the inverter, that's the driver. Okay? So where's the comparator and IR sensor? Where are they? Yeah, where are they? I mean, so what I just explained on the paper, right? You have a comparator, you have IR sensor. That's the main sensing module for the car. That's where the car can really see anything from the environment, right? Where are they?
Ask you to build it.
Because you'll write really bad comment on teaching evaluation survey.
Yeah, let's see how good you can do, okay? If you can get this one done in 5 minutes, you will start another project. I'm pretty sure you will. So hopefully, including today and next week, if I can get this done. And for the very last one, you will learn something really practical. I mean, for the companies in town and anywhere else in Colorado, there are so many companies that are hiring people who knows how to build a PCB circuit. You know, we have so Xiaoyi, which is TA, already developed the entire tutorial for you guys to build a PCB. I think probably we won't be able to send the design to the company and get a fabricated PCB, but if you learn how to do the schematic, how to convert everything to layout and debug it, I think it's really a good skill to have. You can add another line in your CV when you're looking for internship in the summer. PCB design. So these are the IR modules. So this is one pair, has a receiver, has a transmitter. Receiver and transmitter, and let me part that up so you get a concept about what's going on here. Okay. After I lift it from the table, the wheels are not running. Why? No reflection. Is that making sense? So the emitters are shooting downwards, but there might be some reflection of the plane, right? It's too far away. If I put my finger, even though I'm not white, but it's pretty reflective. If I put my finger underneath it, there will be something being received, and you'll expect the wheel will be turned on, right? Make sense? Okay. That's how you verify the circuit. Well, after you build everything, you probably just want to do this really quick and see if that works. Okay, so the amplifier. This guy is on the back of the module, and the potentiometer, the adjustable resistor, is also on the back of the module. The sensor receivers are already soldered on the module. So It has 3 pins. Power. Where's the power pin? God, I enjoy it. But there's a power pin for the device. So every device has a power. You just need to know that. Even though I didn't enjoy it. But there will be a power pin, a ground pin. So the module only has 4 pins. Power, ground, right? 2 of them. Connect power, connect the ground from the module. And there's another pin called DO, DOAO. You write it down. DOAO. So here's the module, for example, okay? VCC, ground, DOAO. Sorry about the writing. VCC, that's the power, 5 volts. Grounded. DO is digital output. AO, just don't do anything for AO. So digital output, what does that mean? What's the meaning of digital output? Is that digital? Come on. Yeah, 1 0s, binary, digital, that's a digital output. So actually analog output is the output here, which is it's not exactly a triangle wave, but it's something, it's a continuous wave, depends on the intensity of the reflection being received. It's doing something like this. But whenever you have a really high gain comparator, it's gonna convert all this continuous change into a digital output. So you can turn on and off, exactly. It's not like in the middle, it's slower, faster. No, it's on and off. That's why you need a comparator. If you don't need a comparator, you are going to see something like...
I know it won't be triangle wave.
Make that perfect, the triangle wave. So I'm going to draw the signal here, okay? Signal here, depending on the reflection intensity, which is VM. So in real life, okay, in real life, VP is 2.5 volts. That makes sense, right? 2.5 volts, which is the reference voltage. And your VM depends on the intensity, it's changing to all the places. It's like, depends on the reflection intensity, can be anything. Because when my finger,
for example, I'm testing this guy with my finger, whenever it's further away from the sensor, I'm getting a weaker signal. When it's closer, I get a stronger signal. Right? So it's something like this. Maybe something like this.
It's not triangle wave at all. It's not linear. So if you have something like this, what's the output looks like? That's VM, right? When VP is larger than VM, you get 1. Then 0. However, 0, when VM is larger than this, you got this. So all these things are VP, which is lower than, wait, am I right? VP is lower than VM here. VM, okay, VP is larger, so it's going to be 1 until here. And this. But still digital, okay? That's still digital signal, on and off for the motor. Just on and off. Any questions so far?
So I will start grabbing all the materials for you right now. So we can take a break. I'll put this one somewhere and we are assembling a cart and take a look at this one. So let's start with, let's see. So before you mount the sensors to the bottom of the car, I will test ever seen on the breadboard first. Because you don't even know if this works, right? So I'll get the cards, I'll keep so you have so many cards on the top, right? Grab one and connect it to this board and put all the chips on the board with the connections, but do not mount it to the bottom and use the finger to test it. If that works, then start assemble the card.
And there's one thing I didn't introduce to you is a breadboard, how to make the connections. You can see on the board, it can be a little bit longer, it can be a different board, but they have the same concept. Plus minus on the two sides. And you can see the red line here. So if you see plus and red line, so the red line is being drawn until the other side of the board, which means all the ports in this column are shorted at the bottom. You couldn't see, but they are shorted. It's just one voltage node, just one wire. You know what I mean? And for the other side, for the other one, minus. So the entire column here are shorted. It's just one wire. Okay? Same thing to the other side. But these two are not shorted. And these two are not short as well, even though they have the same label, plus. But these two columns are not shorted. But this column is shorted, and the minus column is shorted as well at the bottom. So whenever you have a power line from somewhere else from the battery, okay, and you want to short, you want to power it up on the breadboard, you just power up one port, then the entire column will be powered up. So whenever you want to introduce a power line from this, you just plug in a wire and connect to your chip or any component on the board. That's why they designed this in this way. It's super convenient. But for the other part, they're just repeating. So you can see there are five ports, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these five are shorted in one row. And that's it. None of the other ones are being shorted together. So they are like 5, 5, 5. These are being shorted in that row. But between the rows, they are not shorted. And between these two parts, they are not shorted. Only five of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then another row, they are shorted in between each other as well. But only within the five ports in that row. So if I plug in this chip, I bridge the gap and plug into here on the board. Okay, here's a quick question. Are these two pins being shorted or not? So I was saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These five are shorted underneath the board. You couldn't see, but they are shorted. It's one line. And these five are shorted as well, but just in between these five, not to other ports. And the same for the other, for the second row and third row, but only within the five ports in that row, but nowhere else. Okay, so quick question here. Is this port here, which is, is that 30E? 30E, this port? Is that port shorted to 30F? No.
What about this tool?
No.
This tool? This tool?
Yes.
This tool? This tool?
No. So you can have two different voltages, power supplies to the board. Makes sense, right? Okay, if I have this chip plugged into here, so the chip has the metal pins on the two sides. Have you ever seen a chip like this?
Let me grab one for you. Looks like this.
Okay, so look at the pins. So every single pin has a different function. Okay. So that's what you are looking at here. So that's a top view of the chip, of the driver. Oh, not, that's the inverter, not the driver, I'm sorry. So that's a driver. So that's a top view of the driver. And you see a little notch here? That indicates the top of the chip. So if you look at the chip here, also have a notch on the top. Did you see it? Where's the notch? Top. Here. So that's the top, right? So you know if you place it in this direction, and you know what are the pins. That's on the left top side will be 1, 2. That's an enable pin, EN, enable. It's going to enable the driver. Okay, things like that. You know the direction of the chip. If you plug in the chip into the board like this,
is this pin shorted to this pin?
No. Because the two pins of the chip have a different function.
So this is not necessarily to be shorted to here, unless you want to short it.
Or not. You bridge the gap using this chip because you can extend the connection to the pins of the chip. You plug in the chip to here. So you know that this pin is shorted to here. Right? So if this is a power pin, you can power it up from here. Is that making sense? Same for the ground, and any other pins you want to connect any pin on the chip to somewhere else. That's why you need a breadboard to do this job. Any questions?
Okay, here's a power module. I'm going to give you a cartridge like this. And also batteries, so you can test it. So you got to learn how to solder the wires together like this, and you can plug into this jack header. And this power module has 5 volts power output over here. And plug in, did you see?
This is plus and minus, So that's the voltage output of this
voltage power module.
And here's a little jumpy wire. We can unplug it. But we are using 5 volts, so you want to short these two pins together. So okay, 5 volts. You have 2 options for the power module. You can get 5 volts, you have 2.3 volts. But we just use 5 volts. So pull this jumpy wire from here. They are using files option for this power module. Same to here, files. So it's delivering the files voltage to this pin. Okay? And remember, is this plus or minus? This line, this column on the board. Plus. So you need to look at the direction of the board. If you plug in this module to here, plus, the plus sign will be plugged in to the plus column, which is perfect. Same here. All right. So 5 volts will be delivered to where? On the board.
To the right line, the right column. Okay, so it's powered up by this guy in this way.
And also being grounded using the minus pin. We ground the castle pin. Don't think about ground, it's going to the ground. No, it's just common ground. So zero is the voltage reference. Okay, so all the minus or the ground pins should be shorted together on the same board. All right, so we got a 0 voltage reference on the board. Just do it. Don't think about too deep in there. Short all the castle, all the ground pins to one the same voltage connection. So you got a zero voltage reference. So here's a minus pin, here's a minus pin, and connect any ground pins on the chip or anywhere else, so the motor and anywhere, to the same ground line or the blank line. Here. You don't have to short these two columns manually because this module already short this to this and this to this. So you don't have to do it manually. It already does that for you. Okay. Just plug in this one to here, so it's going to deliver 5 volts to the board. And the 5 volts comes from the battery, which is a combine these two battery cells, you are getting 7.4 volts. But after plugging to here to this module, it's going to stabilize your 7.4 volts to 5 volts and being delivered to the board. So it's everything is powered up. Any questions? The motor, so the two motors, it has, if you look at here, right, the motor has a red line and a black line. So it does have a polarity. If you swap the two connections, it's going to rotate in a different direction. Pretty simple to use. Just the voltage is going to start rotating. If you swap the polarity, it's going to rotate in the other direction. If you see it's rotating in a wrong direction, just swap it, and it's going to start working properly. Okay. I think after, I'm pretty sure you couldn't get everything done today. If you start assembling your car, I think you can put it into the lockers. I'm gonna start it. Yeah. I have to grab all the parts from a lot of different places. It takes time. So let's have a 15 minutes break. I'll come back.